Whether you've been living under a rock or on the internet, live streaming services have been taken by wide storm. I'm talking about Hulu, Spotify, Netflix, Primetime, YouTube. Oh, not those two. We don't talk about those two services.
Right. Kinda cringe.
And most of these apps have something in common. It's called cartoons. Whether or not if you're on any of these shows, you'll find something that is animated. Like if you go to Hulu, you'll find Adventure Time. Maybe if you go to Prime Time, you might find SpongeBob. And maybe if you go to Netflix, you might find something good. And that's what we're going to be talking about today, guys. Some of the amazing cartoons that are about to come on Netflix or already was on Netflix. I have a big list here, so I hope it's not too long. Also, I just want to apologize for the long hiatus. I've been doing some art on the side and trying to make my own video game. If you want to know what I'm doing or support me, here is my Twitter. Go check it out and let's get into the video. First on this list is Dogs in Space. Now at first, I didn't know what to expect from this show. I thought it was gonna be boring and I thought I wasn't gonna really like it. But then it kinda just grew on me as I watched the episodes. It's a sci-fi fantasy with character development, and it's about a bunch of dogs going to different planets. I won't give you too much on it, and I think you should go watch it on your own and tell me what you guys think about it. And if you already watched it, make sure you comment down below about it. I think the art style is pretty simple and it doesn't do a lot to woo you over, but I think it has a little charm to it where it feels unique and it has its own flavor. I don't know if the music goes really good. I don't know if I've listened to it, but I think that's all I have to say about this cartoon. It has 2 seasons right now, and I think season 3 will be coming around the corner soon. I wouldn't miss on this show, so yeah, check it out. On to the next one. Next on the list is Bee and Puppycat. I haven't actually seen the show yet, but I've seen the trailers and I have to say, it lives up to what it was born from. It started on Frederator on YouTube and it was a little cartoon series. By the way, check out Frederator, they have a lot of other good shows like Bravest Warriors and a lot of other pilots. And I have to say, the art style is definitely a big change, and I think it got way cuter, and I just can't wait to watch it. Also, the music sounds like it had a big step up, and if you're listening to the music in the background now, this is the music from Bee and Puppycat from the YouTube series. So if you heard this music, and now the music is now better, or it's just improved, or just new, man, I just can't wait to watch it. I've heard a lot of good things about it, and I don't feel like I'm gonna be disappointed. This is definitely one of the cartoons I'll be making a video about. So after I get done watching it, make sure to check into my channel to see when I make it. But with all that out the way, let's get on to the next one. Next on this list is Wendell and Wild. Before talking about this trailer, you've probably seen the stop motion before. If you've seen the movie Nightmare Before Christmas or anything other like Coraline, then you are exactly right. This is the same creator that made those movies. And we're getting a TV show. I just can't wait. All of the sets in the trailer looks amazing, and all of the characters exude energy of just wildness, no pun intended. I've always loved the creepy and the macabre, and I just can't wait to talk about this series. This is one of my just dreams of watching more of stop motion movies. I have seen so many of them that I just can't live without them. So this is on my bucket list to do and to talk to you guys about giving a big review on it. I'll be doing all the notes that I can and talk about all the things that I love about it. So make sure you subscribe and let's get on to the next one. Next on this list is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Before talking about this show, I have a little bit of gripe with this series, or everything that's live action with it, just always fail for some reason, and I don't know why they always try to do it live action. Even when they add like CG or 3D, it just doesn't feel right. But usually I really don't pay attention to that. But when one of my friends decided to show me an old commercial for the live action version, I've never been the same. So the live action commercial starts out in a bathroom or a group shower thing, I forgot what it's called, and one of the turtles come out with a towel around its waist. Now, if you're already listening to this and it sounds really bad, it gets worse. So the commercial is for pickles. Yes, I'm not joking, it's for pickles. And I think you know what it's insinuating. So every single time I think of a pickle, I die on the inside. But enough of that, let's just talk about the Netflix show. Watching the show feels like a comic book, and each scene feels impactful. I love the character designs, and I love how just free they went with it. I love how each character, looking at them, you feel how they act. I'm glad that they embrace the aspect of the characters, how each color defines them, and how their power work together as a team. I think the show is going in a right place. I think it's finished. I don't know if there's anything other than the show and the movie. I've watched the movie before the show and I kind of spoiled my appetite, but I'm still gonna watch it and I might do a video on it. Nevertheless, I think it's your choice to see if you like it or not. But on to the next one. I don't know whether or not to spoil this cartoon because this is one of the best cartoons to ever come onto Netflix. And I think almost anyone and everyone don't talk about it as much as they should. This cartoon is Hilda. Hilda is one of those fantasy and adventure cartoons with a lot of learning between each and every episode. It has two seasons and a movie, and I can't say without a doubt that Hilda inspires animators and artists across the world. It has a beautiful art style where it feels mystic and hidden and overgrown, like it has been there for years and you've just been waiting to discover it. It has a lot of lessons to be learned and just things to remember. I hope more people from this YouTube video can watch this cartoon because it's actually a bang for your buck. Make sure you go watch it, make sure you go see it, and I don't want to spoil anything else for you, so let's get on to the next one. Next on our list is Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared. Wait a minute, that's not on Netflix. Now that I'm thinking about it, it is one of the shows that came out recently, so I guess I'll just talk about it. Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared is one of the most mysterious, funny shows I've ever watched. And every single time I get to watch it, it feels like I've been taken into a different world, a different media, a different place. Watching it makes me feel like I want to discover each and every bit and pieces that it can offer. It only has one season, but I'm pretty sure it will have multiple. The reason why I'm talking about this because I'm making a video on it with my two other friends. And no, I'm not being held at gunpoint. Do not send any help. I do not need it. They are definitely not planning to take all of the credit and not feature me. But there's a lot of things to talk about Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared. There's a lot of art, there's a lot of funny laughs, and there's a lot of mystery behind it. So make sure you keep the notification on when that video comes out. And here's the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I know that I kind of sound a little calm and collected, but I think this type of style of YouTube videos is working for me and I'm going to keep it up. I might try to do something new, try to make something funny in the future, but for now, this is what I'm going to be doing. I hope you guys can, you know, learn from something, and I hope you guys have a good day. I love y'all, and make sure to always subscribe and to love yourself, and oh yeah, watch my Twitter. Goodbye.